taken down like an old gray cat in winter, keeping close to the wall.
Find it to find the money.
Well, I'm fixing to interview Uncle Seymour Washington. Tonight. Seymour Washington from Austin, Texas.
Huh? You had a birthday lately, right?
12th of July.
Uh-huh. You were 36?
79. Born 1896.
Horseshoer all your life, huh?
Horseshoer, dental blacksmith.
You were called the Walking Blacksmith, ain't
that
right?
That's what I was called, nicknamed Walking Blacksmith.
Because,
I didn't have any transportation. I had to catch a bus and then wait for people to pick me up on the ranch, carry me to the ranch. Dripping Springs was my big headquarters. Dripping Springs, Buda, and Blanco.
But you lived here, right?
Lived here, but I'd go out up on the bus to those towns and they'd carry me to the ranch. I got a knack to handling stock, any kind of stuff. In other words, some men go up to a horse to shoeing, and they go up there cussing him and kicking him in the side and jacking him to make him stand still. But you want to go up to a horse's head first and pet him on the neck and scratch him, and I don't care how bad and rough he is, he'll soon understand that you want to be his friend. And you go on and ease with him and handle him careful. And you get, once you get him shod, you'll always know what you want to do when you start to work on it. But if you put the shoe on correctly, the outside of the hoof is where you put your nail. It's just like cutting your fingernails. If you cut your fingernail down too deep there, you got a crippled sore finger. If you stick a nail on the inside of this coronary band and go into the quick and drive it in there, you get blood. And besides, you quick him and the horse is lame for a long time. Probably may go into lockjaw. So it's very technical. Always keep doing something. If it ain't much, do a little. And don't never forget to get out on your knees and pray to God and thank him for the time that he's given you on earth. And from there, go on and talk to the Lord just like you talk to us humans on earth. Live careful and eat three times a day. And eat common, plain food, soul food like beans, turnip greens, cornbread. Drink the best of bourbon whiskey. People condemn whiskey, but they have no right to.
Really?
Because when God created the heaven and earth, he created all things. He also created barley, rye, and if he didn't think that was good for man, he wouldn't let those things grow.
Really?
But he also created cattle of the fields and birds of the air and food for us to subsist on. But he didn't mean for us to eat so much of it until it was detrimental to us, would make us sick. The same thing applies to drinking whiskey, a beer, or anything you drink. You don't have to drink a barrel of whiskey because you see a barrel sitting there. Drink a little bit of it and stop. And ask God to give you the knowledge to do that.
I've seen Unc drink until he had to be carried from the other side of his yard and put into bed. And it didn't take no barrel of whiskey either.
But now then, on the other hand, according to Mr. Van Zandt's statement, he have also seen me sit down where there's a lot of whiskey, like we've got whiskey here now. But he didn't see me drink all of it. I would drink some and walk away from it. And he's also felt kind of embarrassed because he's offered me whiskey and I didn't want it. And he'd asked me, was I angry with him? I wasn't angry. I just didn't want no more whiskey.
That's the first song I ever wrote about.
Is it?
Sometimes I don't know where this dirty road is taking me. Sometimes I can't even see the reason why
I guess I keep a gambling. Lots of booze and lots of rambling. It's easier than just to wait around to die. Every one time, friends, I had a ma. I even had a pa. He beat her with a belt once cause she cried. She told him to take care of me. She headed down to Tennessee. Oh, it's easier than just a waiting around to die. Well, I come age and I found a girl in a Tuscaloosa bar. And she cleaned me out and hit it on the sly. I tried to kill the pain. I bought some booze and hopped a train. Seemed easier than just a waiting around to die. And a friend said he knew where some easy money was. We robbed a man and brother did we fly. They told her to take care of me. They drug me back to Tennessee. And it's 2 long years of waiting around to die. Oh, but now I'm out of prison. I got me a friend at last. He don't drink or steal or cheat or lie. Well, his name's Codeine. He's the nicest thing I've seen. And together we're gonna wait around. Well, together we're gonna wait around.
I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Towns Van Zandt, and this is my dog Geraldine here.
Geraldine, come here. Geraldine.
Good dog.
Back out here in the light. Good dog.
No, don't take her off.
Sure.
Danny.
Okay. Yeah. Now this is my girlfriend Cindy here. Smile at the camera. Okay, now, we're going to first walk around to the backyard. Would you like a drink?
No, thank you.
I have one. Would you hold the gun?
No.
Don't ever aim a gun at a caged animal. Don't ever aim a gun at a caged animal. Okay, now. That dog was hurt running over by a car.
Hi, Zach. You want me to throw a rock for you? Julie.
Let's come on around here to the back. This is this is one of the first oaks ever born on this whole lot. It's 42 feet up to there. I got an intercom up there. I can order Cindy around until she unplugs me.
Oh, damn it.
Which is about, it don't take too long, usually.
Can't you just miss a good shot with the dog looking right at the chickens, man? A black dog. Oh, he ran off by now, but he was sitting right there looking at it.
The big black dog?
Yeah.
Oh, little Smith and little Wesson. Say hello to folks, Smith. These are actually, champion white buff chickens. White buff, B-U-F, like buffalo. this was a possum was trying to get him, but that's all we got left. The old dog got him, just came up there just to kind of nip him right off there. It was either that or a midget, hungry midget. I've raised these rabbits for about 3 years, and I've made my motto, the bigger, the bunnier. It's pretty funny, but I'll tell you what's funnier, the better. See, the bigger the better. Right? And I want y'all to follow me over here, and I'm going to show you one of these holes. I call them holes. Some people call them burrows. They're just the entrance to burrows. Follow me over here. It's not very far. Here's one. I'm talking about some big rabbits. Are you hip? They're like as big as a pig. Easy as big as a pig. This is their latest one. They drank some
come over here and look at this one. We had to close this one up because of the state. The state said close it up.
I don't blame them. It was getting too, now see, I'm serious. It started barreling under here and,
get this off me. Get this off me.
Something's got my leg.
It's got my leg. It's burning.
It ain't out there for him. Out there for everybody else. Keep you free and clean. Now you wear your skin like iron, and your breath's as hard as kerosene. You weren't your mama's only son, but her favorite one, it seems. She began to cry when you said goodbye. You sank into your dream. Pancho was a bandit, boys. His horse was fast as polished steel. Wore his gun outside his pants for all the honest world to feel. Pancho met his match, you know, on the borders down in Mexico. And nobody heard his dying words. And that's the way. And all the federales say they could have had him any day. They only let him hang around out of kindness, I suppose. Well, Lefty, he can't sing the blues all night long like he used to. Dust that Pancho bit down south ended up in Lefty's mouth. The day they laid poor Pancho low, Lefty left for Ohio, and where he got the bread to go. Oh, that ain't nobody knows. And all the federales say they could have had him any day. They only let him slip away out of kindness, I suppose. Pick it, and it won't ever heal. Poets tell how Pancho fell. Lefty's living in a cheap hotel. The border's quiet and Cleveland's cold. So the story ends, we're told. Pancho needs your prayers, it's true. Save a few for Lefty too. He just did what he had to do. Oh, and now he's growing old. And all the federales say they could have had him any day. They only let him go so wrong out of kindness, I suppose. A few gray federales say they could have had him any day. They only let him go so wrong out of kindness, I suppose.
Tony here waiting around to die.